Jim was the writer. He's the guy who had the songs. And, you know, I didn't really think about writing. But then Jim said, hey, you know what? We don't have enough songs, you know. Why don't you all guys go and try and write some too, you know?
Basically, what Robbie had was kind of more of a folk song than it turned into. It goes into the Doors' communal mind, and Densmore says, let's put a Latin beat to it, man.
Like this.
How do we start the song? We can't just... because that's the riff of the song. And I don't know, out of the, you know, the better angels of my unconscious mind came.
Jim came up with the second verse about the funeral pyre. And I said, Jim, why is it always death? Why do you always have to do that? And he said, no, man, this is perfect. You know, you got light, you know, you got the love part of it, and then we'll have the death part. And he was right. The time you
hesitate is through. One night, we finished recording, oh, must have been about 7 o'clock. We weren't working late nights. Only a few times did we do that. Then, and when we were doing the Doors, we did entire days because Jack Holzman booked the facility for the lockout. And we all went home. And I had forgotten to lock the back door of the studio.
Yes, Jim's LSD intake did impinge upon the first recording session. Nothing disastrous, outside of the fact that he went back to the studio after we had all left the studio after doing Light My Fire. We didn't quite get it. Walked in, climbed over the fence, went into the studio. Pam's driving. She's waiting outside. You wait out here, honey. Up and over. Gets in the recording studio, the red work light is on. Just as a, you know, just a light, rather than keep all the lights on, there's a red light in the middle of the room. Morrison, hallucinating on LSD, walks in and sees this red light and thinks, I knew it! I knew it! Grabs a fire extinguisher and hoses down the entire studio. Fortunately, just the instruments. The control room where the really expensive shit was. He didn't go in there. He got our stuff, you know, the drums and this kind of spray foam kind of stuff that was easily wiped off. And then I think he then at that point realized what he had done and said, oh my God, I think I've made a mistake here. I must be insane and hallucinating. Out the door he went, back up the, climbed up the chain link fence, lost his shoe, his boot got stuck. You know, in the chain link, pulled his, and got over to the top, and Pam said, Jim, your shoe. And he said, oh, the hell with it, I've got to go back up and over, forget it, let's get out of here, honey. Boom, off they go. The next morning, the owner of the studio, Tutti Camerata, a certain Tutti Camerata, calls Paul Rothschild, who then calls Jack Holzman, and tells him the studio's been hosed down here. This is not a good thing at all. And Jack said, oh, my God, is it a big loss? He said, no, it can be cleaned up. It's no big deal. And the instruments. And Jack said, well, why are you calling me? He said, because we found Morrison's shoe stuck into the chain link fence. And Jack said, all right, I'll pay for it. It wasn't much, thank God, and he didn't ruin it. But he came in the next day, man, and everyone went, what the fuck? Did you do, Jim? My God.
And it was funny, when he came back in, he was very calm and quiet and very sheepish and went, oh, I'm really sorry. Wow, this is terrible. What can I do? You know, he was very apologetic and very sweet. But he wasn't there. You know, he was there, but he wasn't there. It was Jimbo was there. That song really had it. The thing going against it, it was over 6 minutes long.
Dave Diamond, local DJ, said, man, I am getting requests for Light My Fire. I play it because I got the diamond mine late at night. I can play a long version, but you guys got to cut that thing down and make a single. I'm telling you, it's a hit.
The boys didn't want to cut it. I said, well, look, let's just let Paul see what he can come up with. And guys, if it doesn't work, it doesn't work, and we won't do it.
And we said, no, we can't do that, you know. That's our favorite song. We can't cut it down. But finally we did, and that was Then all hell broke loose after that.
I remember being in New York in a limousine going to a concert. Light My Fire was just breaking, and it must be played every 3 minutes, 4 minutes of one song, then another song, and then Light My Fire again. And we were just in the limo, and our smiles were so big. We were so happy.
It just dripped out of the radio. The Beatles were saying, all you need is love. Morrison's going, light my fire, honey. There's a big difference. It's love, but it's a different kind of love. Then they go on Ed Sullivan.
Ed Sullivan's show was where the Beatles first appeared. Ed Sullivan was watched by families on Sunday night.
Of course, we didn't do what they told us.
They didn't want us to say, girl, you couldn't get much higher.
If I want to say to you, yeah, we couldn't get much higher.
Jim did it anyway, and then they said, you'll never do this show again. And we said, well, we just did it. We only wanted to do it once. Cheers.
Light My Fire hit number one in late July of 1967.
Hey, these guys can hear this. Hey, have you got a cigarette?
And the event of the happening was intense communication. Communication not only within their little circle, but communication with everybody that heard them. And I think this is perhaps related in a sense.
I can try and explain anything.
We think of it as kind of a, we try to provoke sort of a religious experience. You know? And this is what I'm really appreciating.
In the sense of a lot of people communicating in one way.
You know that it would be untrue. You know that I would be a liar. If I was to say to you, girl, we couldn't get much higher. Come on, baby, light my fire. Come on, baby, light my fire. Try to set the night on fire. Time to hesitate is through. No time to wallow in the mire. Try now, we can only lose. And our love become a funeral pyre. Come on, baby, light my fire. Come on, baby, light my fire. Try to set the night on. Yeah, come on, honey.
time to hesitate is through. No time to wallow in the mire. Try now, we can only lose. And our love become a funeral pyre.
Come on, baby, light my fire. Come on, baby, light my fire. Try to set the night on fire.
Be untrue. You know that I would be a liar if I were to say to you, girl, we couldn't get much higher. Come on, baby, light my fire. Come on, baby, light my fire. Try to set the night on fire. Try to set the night on fire.